some niggas can say I changed on them because I thought they was on the same shit I was on, but they not. Or they was on some shit that I wanted to be on, and when I got on that shit, I got on it, then surpassed them, and they was just lost in the sauce.
Jordan Carter was born on September 13, 1996. And when Jordan was a kid, he used to love freestyling. And they said my nigga loved freestyling so much, his family threw dollar bills at this nigga like he was a stripper. Now look, I don't know about you niggas, but if a nigga throw paper at me, niggas throwing money at me, putting money in my pockets, I don't care what the situation is, nigga. Square up, nigga. You're gonna catch these hands, nigga. Weave. At this point, I don't even care no more.
Man, wait, where were we again?
But at the time, he was just a little nigga. So, you know, a lot of shit that he was freestyling, he didn't write it down or make a song about it until later on down into his life and his career. But before this nigga became Playboi Carti and hit the stoop, this nigga wanted to play basketball. He was a basketball player. Now, his grades wasn't bad, but it also wasn't good. And also, he got into a fight with the coach, which tempted him into quitting the basketball team and really taking the rap shit serious. But Jordan's first few songs was recorded on GarageBand. And before we got Playboi Carti, this nigga's name was Sir Cartier. Like, bro, imagine chilling with your homeboy.
Hey, cuz, you listen to that new Sir Cartier?
Yeah, bro, that's Sir Cartier. You're hard as fuck. Or imagine telling that nigga,
hey, bro, turn on that new Sir Cartier, bro. That
nigga, no, I would have hit his ass with one of these.
Don't call me. Don't come by my house. We're done.
In Jordan's high school year, he dropped his first project called Young Misfit. Crazy thing is, you can still listen to this shit till this day, my nigga, right now. He got his first job at a grocery store and later on started working at H&M because he always had like a fashion sense. Like, he was always interested in like fashion. But other than that, he would continue to make music for the rest of his high school year. And also, he also quit H&M because he started feeling embarrassed because a customer asked Jordan if he made music. This is the time where he barely graduated high school to the point his family thought he wasn't graduated at all. But surprisingly, he graduated high school. After graduating high school, Jordan already knew he wasn't going to go to college, so he decided to go harder with his music and created a SoundCloud under his new name, Playboi Carti. Or should I say Sir Cartier?
Brother, this guy stinks!
So one of his homeboys put him on to one of his producers named Ethereal. And, you know, he only works with like a handful of people. He pretty much selects who he wants to work with. So when this nigga heard Carti, he was like,
this nigga hard, wait, hold up, I'm gonna jump my stick leg. You know what I'm saying? It's like, this nigga hard type shit, bruh. So he said, like, work, my nigga.
So Carti and Ethereal started, you know, have chemistry. They started working together. They started doing a lot of songs, started doing, you know, more beats for Carti. And they really started that bond. You know what I'm saying? Helped them bond with more artists. Ethereal would introduce Playboi Carti to a man named Father. And this man, Father, was the founder of this underground label. And this would be the time Carti dropped his first song, Zan Ho. And you can tell by listening, this nigga's before his time, my nigga. But after they started seeing potential in Carti, he was signed to Offer Records. Yes, that is literally the label's name. He was signed to Offer Records, where this nigga would become more and more noticed in the Atlanta scene. But in 2014, he would make friends with another producer who, just like him, is trying to make a name for themselves. And his name was Mexico Joe. Now, Mexico Joe was an up-and-coming producer, you know, just trying to make it, just like Carti. You know, so when Carti started using his beats, it was like he entered another
dimension, man.
And after a while, after linking with these producers and making more and more music, he started to get a wide variety of the mainstream audience. This is when he started to blow and started to see his views and followers start to rise on SoundCloud. He was becoming one of the biggest talks around. But I mean, 2,000 followers would still be classified as underground, though. So, you know, he moved to New York with his friend, but he was sleeping on his plug's floor at the time. And this would be the time him and A$AP Bari first met. They usually would see each other, but they wouldn't say that, but they knew, they recognized each other. But with Carti's name starting to buzz, he would make a lot of more friends in high places. He would start connecting, he would start networking with artists, with producers. He would start doing more and elevating his sound. But like I mentioned before, Carti is a big fashion type of guy. And because of this personality, this would lead him and Ian Carter to become the best friends throughout their years. They were so close. It was to the point that, you know, he was like,
hey, yo, Carti. Hey, man. You should let me manage you, bro.
And this is the time Cardi left his label. As we go deeper and deeper into this documentary, you will understand that Ian played a big part in Cardi's life. Because at the time, Ian would post Cardi's music on his Instagram. He posted everywhere where, you know, he had a large following. However many followers, but he had a lot of followers. And they would tap in. They would tap into Cardi's music because of Ian. Because
niggas ain't shit. Niggas ain't posting my music. Yeah, nigga, you definitely stuck your tongue out, nigga.
Man, shut your bitch ass up. I was stuffing you in the locker on some Disney shit, nigga.
Man, fuck you, Spinem, you bitch. Fuck you.
But gaining millions of plays on SoundCloud, he would then have a blog about himself from Complex. And now he has a million people watching him, watching his every move, paying attention to the new wave of Atlanta music. After all of this new success that Cardi is getting, he also becomes a member of the ASAP Mob. And at this time, he announced on Twitter that the new Cardi tape was coming very soon. But for some reason, the tape never came out, and I don't really know why. Maybe y'all in the comments could tell me why the tape never dropped or anything, because I don't know. But it just didn't drop. And he would go through a long period of time after this, where he really only dropped a few songs like What and V-Lone Thug featuring Uno the Actor. And I think if I can remember, Uno was one of the ones who had a tape with ASAP Mob on one of their tapes, if I can remember. But around this time, this was the start of bullshit. This is when Cardi used to just leave snippets and leaks, which we were fine with, you know, as Cardi fans, my nigga.
But damn, bitch, drop a song, my nigga.
We tired of the snippets and leaks, nigga. Drop the song.
This was Cardi's time right here. He got signed to Interscope Records. 2016 was Playboi Carti's year, the beginning of something that he's been grinding his whole life for. Cardi already has the clout that he wanted. What would Cardi do to finally capitalize on this momentum? A few months starting in 2017, he traveled to ATL and got in the studio with a rapper named K Supreme. When he gave Playboi Carti a beat, and it came from Pierre Bourne, Atlanta producer. And Carti would record his verse on a song called Woke Up, and he sent the song to Lil Uzi for a feature. The crazy thing about it, Pierre was actually upset because he liked to work with people face to face. But they ended up smoothing things out because Carti had a talk with the producer and they smoothed things out. And they became cool. Then Playboi Carti and Lil Uzi started teasing the song on the internet. About a month later, Lil Uzi and Carti would finally meet for the first time in person. Another crazy thing to think about, Playboi Carti had his album dropping. That nigga scrapped his whole album when he started collabing with. When he heard Pierre Bourne, that nigga scrapped his whole album and said, nigga, let's redo this together, my nigga. And you know, Playboi Carti, this nigga going through it. The way this nigga passing up producers, he passing these niggas like a blunt. But once a year, I'm telling you, Pierre, nigga, he said, nigga, come here, my nigga. We're doing this together, nigga. But deadass, after listening to like this nigga's music, after working with this nigga, Pierre, you could really see that this nigga already knew what kind of artist Cardi was. He already knew that. He pretty much he matched this nigga's energy. He matched this nigga's tone. He matched everything that Cardi needed in a producer. I feel like this inspired this nigga Cardi to drop two singles from his tape to give to us, you know, fans. And when I say us, I'm gonna say us because I'm a fan. You feel me? But yeah, it inspired this nigga to drop two singles from the fucking tape. And both of those songs feature Lil Uzi on them. And the two songs were Woke Up Like This and Look In. These songs was hard, bro, because like I said, bro, Uzi and Cardi, dynamic duo, bro. I said that in my last video. Niggas are some demons. You feel me? So these niggas, those two songs dropped. These niggas are dynamic duos. Since because those two songs were such a massive success, it put Pierre Bourne out there. It introduced the world to Pierre Bourne, bro. Who is Pierre Bourne? That nigga's a GOAT, I'll tell you that. Fast forward to Opium, when he started Opium.
Where the fuck my blunt? Where the fuck my cut? Where the fuck my reef?
In 2019, Playboi Carti would sign his first artist, Ken Carson, to the new Opium Records. Then 2 years later, in 2021, he would then sign his newer artist, Destroy Lonely. Then, and in my opinion, these two niggas become a dynamic duo similar to Cardi and Uzi. But fast forward to right now, and Cardi is still doing his thing, still making money, still, you know, blowing up, still, you know, doing a lot of stuff he tried his hardest to get to, and he got to where he came. He got to where he wanted to come, man. So, I don't know, man. I hope this video shows y'all. I hope this video and his whole path shows y'all can do anything coming from anything. You can come from nothing, and the next day it might be your blow up, man. So I hope y'all enjoyed this vid, bro. You know what I'm saying? This is really my first documentary on an artist. You know what I'm saying? Especially Atlanta artist. So I hope y'all really, you know, rock with it. I hope y'all fuck with it. And y'all send me some more requests. Send me some requests on artists y'all want me to, you know, do a documentary on. Go over their life story, their upcomings, their rise, their falls. Y'all let me know, bro. But with all that said, thank y'all for watching, bro. And with all that said, I'm out.